I'm a guy that's 24. Each day I build some more. I like
episode 7 and episode 8.
I'm Rich Boy J.
Hello, boyos. Rich Boy J here back with another video. And today we need to talk about these rumored 2020 Star Wars sets, specifically the April wave, because I find it very problematic. To preface this, these are not my leaks. These are not my rumors. This is me purely speculating on things that we've seen online. I have no inside sources. Literally, don't hold me to it if these rumors turn out to not be true. It is not my fault. But looking at the list, so one of the more exciting things about the sets coming out in 2020 is the summer wave is supposedly going to be all Clone Wars / prequel era sets, which I know a lot of people are excited about. And I think I'm excited about that too. It's going to be a definite change from what we've been getting so far, like the one or two prequel sets we get a year, and getting more Clone Wars sets, more clones, making those figures more regularly in circulation and in updated forms, I think will be a wonderful thing for the community. But before we get all the way to that summer wave, we need to talk about this April wave, because I'm honestly shocked people haven't been talking about this more. So far, the list pretty much goes that we're going to get a buildable Stormtrooper helmet, a buildable Boba Fett helmet, a buildable Dio, and some other set that is priced at the same price point as the other helmets. At this point, I'm assuming that it's just probably going to be another helmet. And this is so problematic for me on so many reasons, because there's not a single playset in any of this wave. Like, how is this even possible? This might be the first LEGO Star Wars wave to not include a single playset, and I find that very troubling, because there's literally just nothing really exciting about this wave. I mean, the buildable Dio, I guess, will be decent. At least for me, I mean, I don't doubt that there are people out there who would like to add these helmets and the buildable Dio to their collection, but I feel like this is counterintuitive to the essence of LEGO, right? Like, at the end of the day, these are supposed to be play sets. Like, every now and again, we get sets that are geared obviously more towards adult collectors, or display only sets like UCS sets and the other buildable droids that we've gotten. But to have an entire wave just be sets like that, I think is absurd, honestly. To put this in the greater context, last year's April wave of sets were the 20th anniversary sets. All playsets, something for everyone to enjoy. So to go from that to this year's April wave being basically no playsets just honestly kind of blows my mind. Like, I never would have expected for LEGO to do something like this. I know some people are going to see this as them kind of switching it up a little bit, diverting from the norm, giving us a wave of different types of sets, which, I mean, generally isn't a bad thing, right? Like, I like when LEGO tries new things. Like, if we're going to expect for LEGO Star Wars to move forward, they're going to have to take some chances at some points, right? But at the end of the day, we should still have that expectation of LEGO Star Wars sets on the whole generally being playsets, right? Like, I'm not crazy for thinking something like that. And a whole wave just dominated by display sets with hardly any play value, hardly any interactability, probably no new minifigures. I don't want to make this a lengthy rant type video, but I would certainly like to know, where do you guys' perspective on this? Like, when I saw the rumored list and I was looking at, oh, like, what cool, like, what sets are we going to get in April? And I didn't see anything that was an actual playset. I was like, that can't be true. But, like, given what we have, it seems like that's going to be the case. And I'm honestly surprised more people aren't talking about this. But let me know what you guys think about it. Are you totally fine with having a wave of sets include no play sets in LEGO Star Wars? Are you even excited by the idea of us getting more display type sets that aren't necessarily play sets? I'd definitely like to know you guys' perspective on this, because I'm honestly, like, I honestly can't even believe that this is actually going to be a thing. Like, I can only imagine being a kid walking into the toy store, you know, looking for the new LEGO sets that are going to be coming out and not seeing a single thing that I can actually play with. Like, I don't know, that's just weird to me. But that's going to finish up the video, guys. Let me know in the comment section below, like I said, what you think about this situation. If you like what I do, go ahead, support the video by hitting the like button, support the channel by smashing that subscribe button, and I'll be back again very soon.